Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second pitch.
Welcome to the boardroom.
I'm Kim Perrell, serial entrepreneur, top angel investor, and best-selling author.
I'm Mark Randolph. I was the co-founder of Netflix and six other companies. I'm an entrepreneur, an investor, a mentor, and host of the That Will Never Work podcast.
My name is Sean Neff. I'm an entrepreneur, investor, and advisor.
My name is Peter Goldberg, founder of PLG Ventures, an early stage venture capital firm, and host of the show.
It's Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Amazon Business, with support from State Farm and T-Mobile for Business.
Who's ready to make some big bucks? Let's hear the first pitch.
I co-founded Fulton with Libby Mochen. We met in business school and have been working on this ever since. We created a product, as you can see here, the Fulton insole. And we launched the company about 6 months ago and have been growing ever since. My chances of walking out of the elevator on my Fulton insoles, I hope, are pretty good. We shall see. It remains up to the judges.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Did you know that 77% of adults in the U.S. suffer from foot pain? I used to be one until a trip to the podiatrist changed my life. He told me that my shoes were unsupportive, and that's why I had foot pain. He told me the solution would be insoles. However, the options were bleak. There were custom orthotics that cost $500, or there was the unsustainable wall of drugstore insoles that just didn't relate to me. So I decided to create Fulton, a modern brand of arch support. We make the world's most sustainable, supportive, and comfortable shoe insoles on the market. Made from entirely sustainable natural materials, Fulton insoles mold to the shape of your foot, taking the proper fit over time. We launched the brand about 6 months ago and have been amazed by the customer response. We've been growing month over month at about 50% after stocking out twice in just a short period. Now, we're asking for $500,000 in the form of a safe note to take our brand and bring wellness to the footwear space.
Four,
who's willing to support
three,
us along this journey
two,
to support the world?
One.
Thank you.
Time's up.
Well, I don't know if anybody suffers from foot pain, but I would love to hear what you thought of that.
It was a good pitch. I think 6 months and 500K, I don't know.
Seems like a good, smart kid. I just like footbeds in a shoe. It just seems like a product that I maybe don't care too much about.
Yeah, I think this is one more example where a good pitch gives you enough information to know, in fact, I'm not interested. So I'm really thinking, is this someone I want to bring up or not?
Well, hopefully we all have the next few seconds to answer that question. So let's vote and let's figure out if we want to hear more. Well, it looks like nobody wants to take the next step. Send them down.
Going down. Oh.
Next time.
I recently found out you went to Wharton. You went from zero sales to 14,000 in just a couple months. Could you have put in a little bit more and brag about yourself in a nice way? Would that have changed the difference? You were a little humble.
Potentially. I mean, my co-founder and I tend to be on the more humble side. We don't necessarily like the glitz and the glam and think that our traction and sort of work speaks for itself, and very proud of the product and brand that we're building. But you know what? I guess in hindsight, it's 2020.
What was your initial thought when you were broken the bad news?
Yeah, I didn't feel too great. I thought my pitch went pretty well. I hit a lot of the points that I wanted to, but you know, that's just the luck of the draw sometimes. Maybe I left a few details out, but still think it's a great brand and want to keep pursuing it.
Yo, yo.
Sean, what's up?
Daniel.
Yes.
I just wanted to say, like, just so you know, like, the pitch was great. Keep your head high. Trust me, we've all been there. I've been there with several businesses. So just kick that door down, right? And I think you have a bright future. Don't be bummed. You and your co-founder, keep up the great work. And then I hope to see a big write-up in Entrepreneur Magazine in a couple years about your success. Cool?
Very cool. Thank you.
Nux, man.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Now, let's hear the next pitch.
Accelerate 35 is the number one hair rejuvenation program in the world. I grew up out here in California for most of my life and just made a lot of friends with celebrities. Sly, Schwarzenegger, Pamela Anderson, Morgan Fairchild, Cher. It's a long ride, it's a great ride. I get to make money and help people at the same time. It's a pretty good life.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, I'm Darian Braun. I own Accelerate 35, the world's number one hair restoration product. Hair restoration is an $8 billion category. It was controlled by one product for the last 23 years whose patent has expired. VC money came in, repackaged product, put it back out, and still made the same claim. You'll see some difference in 4 months. I got bought out for $250 million. And for the last 7 years, I've been in research, development, and production of a product that was inspired by the Native American Indians, the only people in the world that don't go bald. Two clinical trials came in, Accelerate 35, 268% increase in 14 days, 53% increase in length in 45. Proof of concept, 1,000 people on continuity at $89.95. Capture rate is $100, lifetime value $320. I signed a deal with TriStar for 36 countries worldwide. I want $2 million for 5%. Take the ride with me. You got at least a 20X factor. Thank you very much for your time.
Time's up.
I think he might be in the wrong business. I think he should be a radio personality with that voice. Wow. What did you guys think?
I think he should be the case study for how to do a great elevator pitch. We got the product, we got the traction, we got the market, we got the ask. That was pitch perfect.
Yeah, there's something there. I'm kind of like, did we get casted like your ultimate like Hollywood biz looking guy and this is just kind of hired for the day? Or is he a real business guy? It was that buttoned up.
Well, it's time to vote and find out if we're going to get an answer to that question. Well, it looks like all three of you want to hear more. Let's open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hey, Darian.
Hey, how are you?
This is a little more nervous than I thought it'd be. Hi.
Oh, you're
something
good,
tells
man.
Me that you don't get nervous because you look like about the coolest guy going.
Thank you very much.
So all three investors voted to bring you up.
Thank you.
So Kim, kick this one off.
It's impressive. Hi, great to meet. And it looks like you're in a very hot space, honestly, right?
The fun part about the space is it's the same product that's been repackaged that's 26 years old. Their claims you'll see some difference in 4 months. Two clinical trials, you'll see a difference in 14 days. No one can beat us. You can't even catch me on a racetrack. Sorry, I'm actually really nervous.
So this category is filled with suspect claims and main ingredient being eye of newt.
Exactly.
Is this the real deal?
Yeah.
And how do we understand that piece of it?
I spent $1 million and I burnt it. Getting nowhere, doing what you just said, making snake oil. And then I went backwards and said, show me a group of people that don't go bald. Let's start there. There's only one in the whole world. It's the American Indians. So I went to South Dakota and I lived there for a while. And that started this. If you're completely bald, it's not gonna put a head of hair on you that you're like a giant head of hair. It will grow new hairs. It'll take thinning hair that you actually are losing, looking in the mirror, and make it thicker by 268% in 14 days. And I made it for somebody who was sick and grew their hair back. It's just like I made a product for my mother when she got skin cancer. I made her self-tanning towelette. My mom started Absolute Vodka. She taught me marketing. There's not smoke and mirrors. I can sell to you something once, no problem. To sell this over and over to you, that's the difference. I've got 1,000 people in continuity already.
So you said you sold your first business for $250 million?
Yes, sir.
And then your mom started Absolute Vodka?
1981, the Russians knocked down a Korean airliner jet. My mom came back with Sweden, from Sweden with Absolute.
So why are you here asking for $1 million?
I want to make $1 billion this time. I can do that myself. It's going to take me a little longer. With you guys, it'll be a little faster. You know when you believe in something and it's your passion? That's what this is. It's my last deal in my life. I'm 57. I know I'll be bought out in 36 months.
And so it sounds like you're asking for $2 million out of 40. Is
that... Well, for 5%. So 5%. It would be $40
million. Okay.
I'll tell you why. We've got a wholesale division already making money. And I just had another 36 countries that want the product. The commercial's already done. The heavy lifting's done. The I's are dotted. The T's are crossed. And I don't need all the money at once. I'll do in stages. You give me benchmarks, I'll hit them, and we go.
What's your revenue in the last 3 months?
$80,000 a month.
$80,000 a month.
Mm-hmm. Cost of acquisition per customer is about $100. Lifetime value is $322.
Okay.
And I can tell you any number you want to know. Any given week in the United States, you'll have 35 million people losing their hair. I ended up sleeping in my car. And my bankers came to me and said, you're going to go bust. And I said, I don't care, I grow hair. Eventually, it's going to work. And it did. I'm looking to make $1 billion. I can make my mom proud.
Have you raised additional capital so far on this?
I've got partners that are extremely wealthy that don't want me on this show to ask for money. I don't have to. I can show you the text if you want.
No, I don't need to see it. Yeah, but when you say you have partners, are they investors in the company?
Yeah.
How much money have you raised to date?
$1.5 million.
Okay, and then this would be the next $2 million you're looking for. Well, we have a big ask of $2 million. Does anybody want to go into what I think this would be is a negotiation?
So this is the hardest one, actually, I've had to deal with.
Sorry.
I spent the first third of my career as a direct marketing person. I've done direct response television. I've done direct marketing. I've done continuity.
There you go.
I know someone who knows their numbers.
But I didn't get here overnight, by the way. I crawled through glass.
Yeah, same for all of us. But the reason I'm struggling is I'm drawn to saying this would be really fun to be along for the ride. But I'm not drawn to the product. And my gut is just, yes?
I haven't finished. I made the shampoo.
He's gonna get you now.
Made the shampoo and conditioner. Vidal Sassoon's kids gave me their scent from the 80s, so it's back to Vidal, who's my idol for the hair care. And then I turned that into a gel for eyebrows and eyelashes, which women are just going crazy to ask me for.
Yeah, I think it's incredibly compelling. And I know that I'm gonna kick myself for this, but I'm gonna pass. But I'm going to watch this one from a distance with great enjoyment.
Thank you.
I see Sean tapping his hand on his chair. The wheels are spinning.
Yeah, look, I think there's this kind of underdog kind of story, but then there's this also like come in, super flex. I think he pulled up in a limo. To be honest, it feels a little too good to be true. In a unique way, and I say that softly, do you really need help?
Yeah.
Right? Like, that's what I'm struggling with, right? Like, do you really need this funding and help? Or like, to me, I'm like, okay, he's gonna show me a text of a wealthy friend that's ready to write the money.
Yeah, but I need help. I need customer service. I need people with brains, and more the merrier. I'm not gonna do this by myself. I'm not stupid. I'm hungry. And just because I rolled up in a limousine doesn't mean I don't want four of them. Or I want my kids to have a better education than I
have. I like that.
That's a great line.
That's an amazing line.
I want more. But I want more for my kids. I also want to build a hospital back in the Sioux Reservation. I want to give back to these guys that helped us. After $100 million, what else am I going to buy?
I really think you're a unicorn-like human. Seems like you have good passion. I think I'm out just based on, I don't know if you need my money, because it feels like you might be able to be fine with one limo and not four. So I'm out.
Okay.
Yeah, I would go with these guys, which is a perfect pitch. Something just doesn't add up to me. So, and maybe it's the sleeping in the car to the cell. Something doesn't add up. So I'm out.
Well, unfortunately, the deal was not meant to be today.
Thank you very much.
But we wanted to wish you all the best.
I
know Mark
it.
Is going to be watching you from the sidelines with great interest as well.
Please send an email. Send your product.
Will do.
Great.
Hey, good luck, man.
I appreciate it.
All right.
Have a great day.
Good luck.
Have a good one.
I love the fact when people are dramatically different than me.
Mm.
I find that experience actually even better. My reason for saying no, which I wasn't able to articulate, was my spidey senses were going off. And I had to go, I've got to listen to that inner voice.
Yeah, you have to listen to your intuition. The numbers look good, he looks like it looks good on paper, but my gut is just, something's off, right?
For me, it was like, I sold my company for $250 million. My mom started Absolute Vodka.
I rolled up in a limo.
I mean, if that, and rolled up in a limo.
I slept in my car.
And his watch, and his necklace was, he could sell his necklace and literally take a third of the funding down that he came here and asked today. So it's kind of like, I don't know. It was a different deal, but like kudos to him for coming in like that.
All three investors said that something just didn't add up. It felt off.
Okay.
What do you think that you were not able to do to get them to get that feeling that something was off? Because it was unanimous.
I don't need them.
You don't need them.
I didn't come here because I needed them. I came here because I wanted to. That's why I asked for $2 million. They're really nice people. They thought it was a perfect pitch, and it was. The money's a different story.
And now today's Main Street Hero of the Week, supported by State Farm. Vanessa Hamath of Helix Painting is a hero to local nonprofits and homeless shelters as her company brightens up these spaces with free paint jobs. Thank you for being our Main Street Hero of the Week, supported by State Farm. Learn more at statefarm.com/smallbusiness. Now let's hear the next pitch.
So my uncle is the original inventor of pure air when my cousin was younger. She was very sick, allergic to everything, could not be outside, could not participate in a lot of events and things that normal children would due to asthmatic pests, different kinds of breathing conditions. We're getting COVID tested with the EPA right now. We've got a meeting set up with them. So we're looking to complete our certification. We're just trying to help people. And that's something that all of us are very passionate about, very philanthropic in all of our activities and things that we do, the entire family.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hello, Mike Bernholtz from Pure Air, co-founder and CEO. We've been in business for over 12 years, creating eco-friendly products that protect our environment and people. Our current products, so we have some sprays and filters that are lab-tested to eliminate black mold, E. coli, staph, all kinds of different bacteria out of the air, all cleaning the air, protecting people. We're here today asking for $750,000 against a company valuation of $5 million to complete our EPA certification to be a COVID microbial cleaner for surface and air, as well as continue our TV and our digital campaigns and increase our high volume manufacturing. Our products can increase the life of produce, take care of unwanted odors in factories and homes. Wouldn't it be great to control the airborne sicknesses in the air, protect our homes, our families, and our schools, and get people where we're not having people get sick anymore. These will clean the air and the soil and the dump.
Time's up.
He's looking for FDA certification, been in business 12 years. It's an important topic with air purification. What was your initial reaction, Kim?
I thought he did a good pitch, but again, 12 years, I'm just not sure.
You know, I'm always torn between someone who does a good pitch and potentially an opportunity, but it's a category I may not be particularly interested in.
Yeah, I think for me, the big red flag is he's been at this for 12 years, and it seems like he hasn't figured it out.
Well, it's time to vote to see if somebody or all of you want to hear more. Well, unfortunately, it looks like nobody wants to hear anymore. Send them down.
Going down.
A lot of the feedback in the boardroom was that you've been at this for 12 years. And even with additional money, if you haven't cracked the nut by now, why is your 13, 14, 15 going to be any different? How would you address that?
Well, this is a new product after 13 years. We've made a plethora of other products, so this is brand new.
Oh.
So I probably didn't say that well enough or describe that well enough, but this is a new product we just came out with. We've made creams, we've made all kinds of different filtration. My uncle used to use it for the soil cleanup for down the Texas and the oil rigs, all those kind of things.
Well,
so this is a new product.
Thinking back at the pitch, do you think that came out clear enough that multiple judges had the same assessment that it wasn't new?
It didn't come out clear enough. That's obvious. I thought they wanted to know how long, you know, we've been in business and those type of things, kind of some of the asks, you know, of the presenter. So that's why I said that. So,
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Now let's hear the next pitch.
So I think I have a different perspective than the other people pitching because I've been here before. First time I was here, I was so nervous, and I didn't end up getting a deal. But I'm gonna change that today, because I am not nervous, and I am here for all these women.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Amy, and I'm the founder of Proov. If I look familiar, it's because I was here on season one. I had a crazy idea to take your phone, turn it into a powerful fertility clinic, measuring hormones, connecting to doctors, and getting women pregnant fast. I have news to tell you, it is now a reality. Because a government grant and investment by a major diagnostic company, this is a reality, and we've already helped over 100,000 women. I was told I needed expensive IVF, but I proved them wrong because my little miracle is now 8 today because it was a simple hormone imbalance, and that's why I founded Proof. This little guy is Liam. My sister went to a doctor. She used Proof. It had negative results. She got a medication. She had this beautiful little baby. So please, I'm raising $1 million to fill a million of these onesies. Please help us make more dreams a reality. Thank you.
Time's up.
Well, that was high risk, high reward by having the kids in there and a kid crying. So it'll be interesting to see what you guys think, if that ultimately was beneficial or not.
Well, you know, when I saw how many people were in the elevator, I said, we should be filing this under W for what is she thinking? But I found it strangely compelling. Mm.
It's the story of my life. So actually, I could hear everything she said crystal clear.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing stronger, right? If you're talking about your product and you're saying the end result is this cute little kid, it's pretty heavy.
So it sounds like you guys, who are all parents, ultimately can relate to that. Anyway, time to vote, and we're gonna see if we're gonna open the doors and learn more. Well, it looks like the three parents are all thumbs up and want to hear more. Let's open the doors.
Woo!
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hi, guys.
Hey. Brought the party.
So it looks like you were on season one.
I was.
You're back on season 7.
I am.
And you've shown the investors that you've been able to really grow this. You're looking for $1 million.
That's right.
Kim, who's got 4 kids.
Yes.
You've got to take it away.
Congratulations. It's great to see you back. And would love to learn about where the product's at currently and 100,000. Is that what you said?
Yes. This company started in 2016 in my basement. We funded it with bootstrapping from an Indiegogo campaign.
Awesome.
And then we got some government grants. So $1.5 million non-dilutive.
Wow.
And then we got a major diagnostic company to invest in us and some angels. And we are just killing it. We are helping so many women get pregnant.
So clearly you've done some amazing things, but I'm assuming it's a for-profit company. What are the average selling price for this? How many have you sold? What are your revenues?
So we sell different types of kits that measure different hormones across the cycle. Our biggest one is the Confirm kit, which helps you understand if you have a good ovulation quality and your hormones are balanced. That's a $30 kit. This is a $60 kit. It measures all 4 hormones across the cycle.
So what were your revenues last month?
Over $200,000.
Wow.
We have a large community on Instagram and Facebook where we offer support, we offer education, you know, empower them to have better conversations with their doctors. We are not profitable yet, but we are well on our way.
Wow, who were the other investors? Any notable investors?
Yeah, we have a major diagnostic company that I'm not allowed to disclose on TV.
Okay.
They came to us and they said, we are looking for the fastest growing women's health company, direct to consumer hormone monitoring. They came to us and they're like, you know what? You are killing it. You're all over the search. Like, you know, you have a great education strategy, you have a great product, you have good patents. We have 3 patents that have been issued, a lot more pending. We have a great technology. We have a database of all the hormones that we own. We take the fertility clinic and turn it into your phone. No external devices. It uses machine learning, captures the results, has all these algorithms that tell you, you know, what's going on, next steps. We connect you straight to doctors if you need a doctor. It's a really powerful system.
And what's the valuation?
$30 million.
Why did you laugh when you say that? You can't believe it?
I don't know.
So you have 8.5 committed. You're not giving us confidence now. No,
this is something I invented in my basement after my own personal battle. And the ability to help people is so rewarding, and it's grown and grown and grown. And so, yeah, I just can't believe it that we're finally here at this point where we've helped so many people.
Well, I've never seen a little one running around the room throwing cups while you're asking for $1 million. There's always a first.
You didn't have a fertility company in here, I guess.
Investors, what do you guys want to do?
Yeah, so look, I think for me, you know, my wife and I, similar thing, we have one through IVF, one natural, and then we tried to get the third. So I have a 14-year-old, 11-year-old, and an 18-month-old. So we tried for a long time. So I've been there with my wife, right? It's challenging, it's tough. I'd be willing to throw, let's say, 150 grand in the pot, right? And basing that on just trying to make more beautiful children like that are in the room. So for me, I don't know enough to be deadly. Maybe that's why the check size is not $1 million, but I think I'm intrigued enough and just that good idea of making more children or making the process easier on amazing mothers would be something I'd love to be involved in.
Awesome.
I love the mission. What you're doing is a very, very compelling reason to want to be involved. I just don't understand the model well enough. And I'm old-fashioned enough that I do like to couple mission-driven investing with money-driven investing. And so I think I'm gonna have to pass.
I love the mission. I also love that you're just so focused while there's chaos happening right now, because I've never seen a baby in a boardroom either. But with that, I really see the challenge, and I think you found a simple solution, and that's what I think a lot of women need. So I'd love to invest $250,000 at the current round.
Awesome.
You have Sean that's willing to throw in $150,000. You have Kim that's willing to put in $250,000 on the current terms. Who do you want to choose?
Okay, we got it. All right, since she's the birthday girl, you tell him. What did we decide?
Kim.
Yay! I am awesome. Thrilled to be on this journey with you guys.
Thank you so much.
Go crush it. Make more babies.
Yeah. I know. No more.
Make more babies for other people.
I'm out.
Other people babies.
Well, we have one more birthday present, but this one's for the company. On behalf of their support for small business, State Farm would love to present you with $3,000 cash prize to help support and grow your business.
Wow, that is amazing.
Congratulations.
Awesome, thank you so much. I'm so excited, appreciate it.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. I know you were asking for $1 million, but did 250 actually exceed your expectations?
Absolutely, and it couldn't have come from a better person. I might have stalked Kim online before I got here, and I knew that's who I wanted on my cap table.
What do you think Kim's gonna be able to help you do to get to the next level that you're looking for?
Push us to be the best. Women on our cap table make us stronger. A woman investing in a woman-owned company keeps us on our A-game, keeps us going strong.
Are you planning on coming on Elevator Pitch a third time?
I don't know. I might have another product up my sleeve.
To apply for season 8, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.